23rd, they're meeting with the Tri-Trail Alliance. By the way, Matt Johnson just, so then, we're gonna take them over to the Seaver, come April. We discussed the school referendum, and we discussed the Tri-Trail Library Agreement, and how we get that thing out of debt center. Problem is there, is we need to get the High Power Committee to get an answer from the library. How they cut their form, there's no way to do that, so. Nothing else to happen on there, we did have a discussion on trails, as you know, you're the act, South, Mary Baptist, the oodles of rural hours on a trail between Village of Bushering and Village of Barnwell, where it's town. We got too far along the way, we even had agreements between the two municipalities to go ahead, but we could not get a buy-in from Walworth County or Waukesha County, because they both wanted to know, I'm not really working, so, yeah. The chances then is, the more funding mechanisms out there, number one, and number two, part of the track two, I believe, lands in the building here, Friday, is to get into part of the trail system in the village, and part of the permits, part of this west end, that approach the rural museum and village, but reacted to it all. So we're gonna meet here, we're gonna date you up, we also got the meeting date, April 11th. If you get one from Mary, I'll be in that meeting. But anyway, there's a meeting coming up. Also, coming up here on the 19th, which, working out, I'll be sharing the County Association Tri-County Meeting, in Waterford, to assume all of the commercial parties, crime association. And then we also have some training coming up in February, and we hand out to Kim, she'll probably bring it up during future meetings, to see if we're under that, if it's a lot on Saturday, pretty much all day. And then also, and it's not on the agenda, because we're not gonna act on it yet, I did get the state municipal agreement from the DOT for the Title 20 project in the village. And in order for us to sign that agreement, we need to have an agreement signed with the village, and we don't have that yet. When we get that, we can sign this, and hoping that the way the training comes out, that possibly one of the special meetings we have, we have some more to see. There's kind of a month or two deadline coming on this. I didn't get a specific answer yet from the DOT, but they'd probably like it sooner than later, like a month. So, that's gonna be coming up also, and when we get that, it'll kind of be part of our special meetings. So that's all I have for, okay, that's how it works, aye?
Everybody receive copies of our report? Any questions for that? Okay, I did one new follow-up for cost we have a, one of our part-timers runs the smaller truck, so he's not at the rate that we're at. He's at $25 an hour.
So then there may be other people?
But we're publishing the March part of that rate, there's not like $45 an hour.
But those are for the full-time people, not the part-time people.
The full-time people.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true, right, yeah. So the $25.
Do we document that, I mean, if someone asks, we can show them that, that really it's only the part-time guy that does the private road.
You should probably list that in here.
Okay.
As well, that very well, this is gonna be a living document, so, cost change, this will change. And what we're gonna do at budget time, so it's enough time for him to know what it's gonna be for the special assessment on these 259 addresses. We're gonna use a, I thought three running average, but how much, you said 22, 23, how many years worth of documentation do you have?
I have 3 years.
You have 3 years. So by the time we get to this fall, will you have 4 years?
Yeah, one 4 year.
Okay, so we're gonna use a 4 year running average, and then a year later, probably use a 5 year running average. I don't know if we want to go beyond that, but that would be something that we would talk about during. So right now, we have a, this is for 22 to 23 events, a 3 year running average.
Yeah, because I know you said we already did 9 in December.
Yep.
So that would leave like 10 more based on this rate. Although December probably comes in 22.
It's the 22, 23.
Okay, season, the season.
Yeah, this is probably season.
So it seems like.
13 left if you're at 22, but.
Well, this $35 works out to actually like 1. Yeah, I think $177. And we already used 9, and then the container cover in March.
No, there's nothing in January yet.
So, yeah, this, we won't get a meeting in January.
Okay, so this will be sure everybody's on the same page here. All the other rates you have in here, that includes the labor.
Yes.
Okay, one we have specifically called out is the long time, that's the part-time guy, that's why that's listed at the 25.
Yes.
That's correct.
Yes.
Alright, so, okay.
There's also a question that we're only doing some private roads, not all private roads, is that correct?
Correct, there is a handful of private roads that they don't want our service. The ones off of, there's some off of, Stone School and Old Breezy, Brassy, and I don't have Elizabeth.
And I think because they have their private airstrip, they don't want the salt.
Yep.
To affect the planes, and that's why they're.
And then there's a couple that are just a regular gravel road with, Casal is one off of Honey Creek Road. It's just a gravel road that's more of a driveway, but it's listed as a road.
We would typically call something like that, right, unless it's paved?
Well, we have one Lucy Lane, but 9 times out of 10, unless we have 3, 4, 5 inches of snow, all is gonna go down.
Great, it's a good segue then. I'm handing out to you folks a copy of the latest on the town of East Trade Roads. I've been working on this for at least 5 years. Looking at 170 years of records to the site, and 2 quarters of the way done. What I handed out to you here shows in red the change they just made today. Okay, for instance, Dan Lane was one of the questions, oh, that's a private road. No, it's not even playing a private road, the driveway.
Yes.
And it was a perpetual easement, ingress and egress, okay, the driveway, okay, so it's not even a road. First Avenue and Second Street, those are 2 roads there by Lane's, we're gonna be adding those to our mileage, chart for next year. It's only 1,100 of a mile, but we gotta get that on there. And then the last one is, Lucky Lane, that was a question, you said, why is it private road? That's not. It's a ingress and egress easement only, it's a private driveway to one resident, so 40 acres back in the woods. Okay, so that's not a road either. So a lot of these questions that are brought up, document I'm giving you here, you know, started out as just all town roads, but as I know, when questions came up on some of these, you'll notice on here where it says where, you know, town board action, need an affirmation that this road is private. One of them, what is that one road where it passed a concrete course?
West Bay.
What's it called, West Bay?
West Bay.
Look on West Bay there, and you'll notice last page, it says there was a resolution 90-9, affirmation of West Bay Drive as a private road, okay? And it actually was, it's 73, but we did the resolution in 1990. So again, that's a private road, but some of these are just easements, they're not even a road, they're not even a private road. They're not town road, they're not a private road, they're a driveway, okay? So I'll be adding some more of those on here, because I see that those questions come up. Again, this is meant to be a living document, so I'm gonna keep working on it, so. Okay, so, back to your.
Have those easements and driveways been brought to the attention of Mr. Ken Bess?
Yeah, I responded to him on Lucky Lane. And I don't even know if he asked specifically on Dan Lane, if it came from you or from Dan, somebody mentioned.
Yeah, he had a list one day.
Yeah, he had a list of like seven or eight roads, they're not roads, they're not private roads, they're driveways or they're easements.
I think the only one that was on there that is, was Slayer Lane, but part of that's ours, part of it's private.
And follow up with all of this, you're gonna be authorizing Attorney Mills to look at the snow plowing contract that kind of ties into what you have over here. So this is a living deal, we're gonna do our due diligence, we're gonna make sure it's right. If we have, you know, three-year running average, probably about a four-year running average, when we do the numbers this fall, I think that's gonna be a fair, as fair as it can be. Again, we shouldn't make money, we shouldn't lose money, and this is a service, you know, to our town residents, you know.
Do we have an obligation to plow those roads in order for them to be serviced effectively by police, fire, and EMS?
That's a good question. We know how good our snow plowing is, and when our regular roads are plowed, so are these private roads. That's ensuring access for fire and rescue right there.
Right, and police.
And police, okay, so that kind of is a thing in that favor, okay?
But I don't think we can assume that if they hire a private contractor, we would not have access. If they were expected to hire a road private, because it's a private road. Yeah, I don't think we can assume that it would only be serviceable if you plow it.
I wasn't making that assumption. I was just saying that it needed to be plowed in order to effectively get the best service from police, fire, and EMS. And to make sure that those vehicles have the least amount of damage done to them, because the road is plowed.
And we also, when some of these roads get to a point where they're falling apart, and if the guys can't plow the road, or the fire chief says, I'm not taking my equipment down there anymore, then all the people in that, and the town road get the notice that, hey, you better fix this thing, or, you know.
That Bob knows very well.
So that's kind of how it works, it all ties together. What I'm getting at though is that Attorney Mills is gonna be looking at this, the contract component, and make sure we already have our, legal advice was given to us. Normally, that's not shared with the world, since all the questions were coming up on it. Last month, we actually put that in our package. I don't know if that was a good thing or not.
I was wondering how that got on that.
Yeah, there was a discussion, Kim was getting a lot of questions on it, and we said, okay, let's just cut this right to the quick. Just put it on there, and be done with it. And we did. Like I said, I'm having second thoughts about doing that, because in effect, our attorney is giving legal advice to the board.
Well, it's no longer confidential either.
It's what?
Once it's shared, it's no longer confidential.
And that memo wasn't marked.
No, but Jim Dunley doesn't mark his, well, you do.
On letters, I do.
Yes, on letters, so. So I guess what I'm getting at here is this, you know, we're kind of done for this now, but that doesn't mean that we're gonna stop study this until we make sure that everything is good, okay? We do know how it's gonna work for us, okay? We do know what roads are doing, what roads are not. I did add those two driveways on there, just so you know, they're driveways or not roads. And then we'll have that four-year running average come budget time, and I think we'll have a fair, good number that we can argue, I would think.
Well, and another reason why I'm asking for authorization later is not only can we firm up liability and protection issues, but since we're adding things on to a tax bill, if the Department of Revenue would ever ask, it'd be nice to have a piece of paper that we can tie to a specific property.
Yeah, well, and overall, I think I appreciate Mr. Just bringing this up, because I think it is something that we should be documenting, how we calculate it, why we're doing this. I think it's a good due diligence for us to go through and make sure that it's an annual review during the budget process. And I think we probably haven't glazed over it the past couple of years, because it's just kind of something that we've already done. So I think this was a very good exercise. Thank you, John, for putting in the time. And I think, yeah, this kind of document should be included with the budget every year. And I think, like I said, we have to follow up on contracts and in one of our special meetings, make sure that we're all good with this.
Yeah, and again, how long was it right here, 20 years, 30?
Forty-one.
Forty-one, he says, and he's been gone a year or two, so it's been at least 45 years that this has been occurring, okay? And every year that he's added in the budget, I mean, it's gonna be the only guy that, it's, well, that's, is that number right, okay? And normally Greg would look at it, you know, and say, here's where we're at, it's close. We're gonna have more data now to prove that, you know, we're close, right?
Yeah, it was, I don't know, 10 years ago, probably, so maybe, kind of that, we actually changed it from, I think it was 25 to 30.
25.
Yeah.
So it's one of the last resolution I drafted, and it does mention contracts. But that was copied right from the statute.
Yeah, it was 2016, and 2008.
The 2008, resolution also, so the 2016 is kind of copied.
It's just a first change.
Yes, yes, so, okay.
Joe, may I ask a question of you, Kim, Todd? Any of the 259 households, those are only taxpaying households, any comments from them, have they offered any discussion?
Not that I've heard.
And I think they're extremely grateful that the town does provide the service. They're very grateful.
I don't think they want to know what a private contractor would charge for.
Private contractor would be worth something.
And I don't think they would get the service as quickly as we do, even if private contractors come out, when they get all their other stuff done.
It's not gonna be a $1.77 per address per apartment.
More like $177.
Yeah, and Bob can attest to the fact that, how are you gonna get 52 residents on a street to agree to a vendor order and sign on their contract and pay their portion?
Well, Mr. Ted Zest is accusing us of.
Not Ted.
Ken.
Ken, sorry, apologize, Mr. Ken Zest is accusing us of thwarting free enterprise, obstructing what private contractors could do. And I think our due diligence here is that to be incorrect. Follow the law, be reasonable, provide public service. My only concern is, will we include his, as he requested, his Saturday, January 7th email asking for this
public comments
being included?
I think the public comments will be included in the record. And actually, I'm going to read the conclusion, and I'm going to give that to Attorney Mills, because he should also check that and he does his deal on the contracts. Okay. And you already addressed
responsibility.
Yeah, building responsibility, and you already addressed that, but you know that again. So, and matter of fact,
you have one of them.
Right.
That's fine.
You can respond, you work, and you can respond to anybody's, or you can go off. And that was that accusation of the meeting, which we know could occur. It's not, wasn't the meeting, you know, so. Yeah, but I'm gonna.
Your next one?
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, any other questions for, Todd? Thank you.
Just on the furnace in the DPW and the other one, was that part of the question?
It was not, but we still had money in our shop fund. Yeah, for 2022, to replace them with that, and hopefully, we don't have as many major repairs on power trucks this year as we did last year.
How old were those furnaces?
42 years old.
42 years. One went to hell, so we replaced that, and then we looked at the other ones.
Yeah, they looked at the heat exchanger and the other one, and it's cracked.
Yeah, so.
And that's actually gonna get done on 16, replace that.
Okay.